Business partner of mine, he texted me and said, "Hey, this guy wants me to do some last minute show with, like, I don't know, Jamie or some singer on November 25th in Houston." I said, "Okay, cool. Let me we discussed the price, and then that was it. I hang up. I mean, I finished the text message. Then I just go to IG. The first thing I saw was like remembering Takeoff. I'm like, what is this? Is he doing like a list of his songs? Like, what's going on? You mean, like, what happened? Is this somebody that was it robbery? What is it?"
No, so allegedly there was a dice game, and it was some an argument that broke out, and some shots were fired.
Dice game, like money.
Yeah, but I don't think that he was I don't think he was involved in the actual dice game, but he was there. And
There with their security.
I don't think so. It was a private party. It was some private party at, I think, a bowling place.
He said his friend shot him accidentally.
Yeah, because it's saying that some of those shots came from someone that was in their crew.
His own crew.
Yeah. Not sure. You know how the
Yeah,
internet works.
that's what everybody's saying in the comment. That's what they're saying in the comments.
Yeah, but still, yeah, it's that's not how you want to wake up and see, you but you can't help it if your phone is blowing up about it, but it's, oh my God.
You gotta be kidding.
It's and then there's video, so please, no one, if y'all see that, don't repost that video. There's a video too.
Arena shot him in the head or neck area. What
Yeah.
is August might put out is
Yeah. And then there's a and then the baby, the artist, and I know
Davido, yeah, that day is just it's just crazy back to back. I mean, how you lose your 3-year-old son? So what the whole thing with Davido's son, so I'm they say he drowned, but it's like he drowned a few days ago. But he just died yesterday. So he was in a hospital the whole time. They like since the 21st, I think.
Oh gosh, I'm lost for words right now. It is it's a sad day. It's a really sad day. I don't even, this is,
The sad about it is like these killings happens almost every day to just the common unknown people that we don't know. People out there losing their brothers and their uncles and their cousins. Yesterday I went to a Halloween party up in the hills and have no clue. All of a sudden, like an hour later, I'm like I heard there was a two people arguing and a girl's get shot. Which was I think it was a bus. There was a bus that was hauling people to the private party area. But I guess it happened right around where the bus is. I'm not quite sure. Sometimes you gotta do bus because you don't want the whole everybody knowing your address, especially we just live in a house in the hills. These hills houses in the hills are not in no gated area. Houses are not gated. Of course, you want to like, you want a bus to haul everybody there. That when nobody's in there in their car, nobody can bring no gun, nobody can do. It just get and then somebody a female accidentally gets shot when two guys are arguing. Somebody pulls out a gun and a girl that had nothing to do with it gets shot. And I'm 99% sure she passed. But like we don't nobody really know the real answer. So that they kept everybody inside the party. Till police came, ambulance came, and like, people couldn't leave till all this disaster was over. Our young kids are getting out of hand. When I'm talking about young, like, I'm talking about like these 20 something year old, the 30, it's getting crazy out here.
We have 14 people before I went to bed last night. I don't know what the update is on it yet because, you know, takeoff and that's just, you know, that's covered. That's on everything, on every media platform. But last night in Chicago, we had 14 people shot at one time at a outside. And the youngest victim was three.
Drive-by, right?
Yeah, 14 people. And the youngest victim, don't know the condition, but was three. A three-year-old. And it's freaking Halloween. So, I want to stay in the house the rest. I want to stay in the house the rest of the year. Like,
unreal. Like, it's just unbelievable. I mean, you arguing about dice game with money, and then all us, then we taking lives
because dice of games money. Dice games have always been dangerous, always. Yes. And as a fan, I'm a gambler myself, you know, but in a controlled environment, dice games have always been, you know, street dice games have always been dangerous. I don't understand because it's just, I mean, such, and you know, he was the quiet one out of the group and, you know, just, it's unbelievable. It's a sad day. And I mean, it's already been sad in hip hop, but it's just an even sadder day in hip hop. And just these, our rappers, every day I look up, we losing a rapper. I just saw a video of Designer. Is it Designer? He's on the internet. He's crying. He says he's done with rap. He's done with this image. He's done with all of this. Like, it's fucking, it's dangerous. It's really dangerous. It's dangerous.
And it's always, if for some reason, it's always some, in, like, it's a dice game. People are arguing, and then look, Smitish, he gets shot. Probably has nothing to do with what's going on.
Never.
And now it was accidental shot by somebody that in his crew. Like, we holding guns and don't know what to do with it. We don't even know how to use it.
Listen, Mike, I was just doing some training, I think like a week ago, firearm training or whatever. I'm really big on that. I need to start posting more of that on my page. I'm really big on firearm training because it's always the innocent ones. It's always the one who don't know, who didn't have anything to do with it. Like, y'all around here carrying guns and don't know how to fuck to use them. And it's so frustrating. Like, they never hit their fucking target. You know, it's just always the innocent one. Like, go take some classes. Like, this shit is not GTA. This is real life. And they carrying these guns and don't know what the hell to do with them. Oh my God. I don't know. I don't know. In Houston, oh my God, we just, I want to say a month ago, maybe, Chicago, we lost a great jeweler. He was in Houston and he was murdered. Like, I don't know. We need to close Houston down and we need to stay in the house the rest of the year because I don't live off of fear and, you know, God first, but we're living in a very, very, very angry, tough time right now. People are not in their right mind. The fucking shit is fucked up and people are losing their goddamn mind. They're not thinking. Like, this is sweet. It's heartbreaking. It's really heartbreaking. I want everybody to stay in the house. Seriously. I don't know.
My thing, man, life is so short as it is. Like, how are we, you know, and it's just us ticking our own life. It's just black people killing black people. Like, you know, not saying we should go kill anybody else, but like, these are us just ticking. I never understood how, who gives these people power to be, my thing, you pull a gun out and start to shoot, is 99% you're going to take somebody's lives. So now you got to think, what has this person ever done to you? Is your life, is your life in danger? You know, I mean, when you do a drive-by, we just going around just trying to just kill a whole block. Like, you got innocent people just walking by that has nothing to do whatever the hell is going on in your fucking head.
I have no clue. And then what is the aftermath of when you go, when you turn on your phone or you turn on the news and you see that your fucking dumbass shot a three-year-old? A fucking innocent three-year-old.
So crazy.
How do you feel? Like, how do you feel after? Do you feel stupid? Do you, your boys who you was in the car with, do they be like, yo, you dumbass motherfucker, you just shot a three-year-old? Like, this is, they, I don't, what goes through? I have tried to tap into every side of my brain and nothing in me tells me, let me go and get in my car or whoever and go just start shooting up the fucking block. Like, I don't know how, I don't know if people think that these guns are toys or whatever it is, but you pull that motherfucker out, you're going to do some serious damage. And 9 times out of 10, it's always to the wrong one.
My thing, I've never been a fan of guns. Never been a fan. About, let me see, when I got my house in the East Coast, about 10 years ago, maybe. Maybe long, like 10, 11 years ago, I was like, okay, you clear, you go and buy a gun. Like, we check your background, you're good enough to have a gun. I'm like, okay, I went to the gun store, you know, I did all the paperwork. When it's time for me to go get the gun, I'm like, what am I going to do with this gun? The thing about a gun is, like, you know, when you have a gun and then the next person has a gun, then it's bad. Like, I'm like, I've lived 40 years of life without a gun. Like, you know, I always put my faith in God. Like, a gun, to me, is nothing that the public, I've never been a fan of people carrying gun. The whole Texas law and Georgia law and Florida law of gun, stand your ground. I've never been a, you know what, in Africa, we don't have this problem. You know why? Nobody's allowed to carry a damn gun. we have to protect yourself, this and that. I understand that, but nigga, if nobody had a gun, most of us would be alive right now. And I know I'm just speaking out of anger, and I cannot say that because people have to defend themselves. But what I'm saying, if the next person didn't have a gun, I know you have to defend yourself against that guy that has a gun. But if he don't have a gun, then what? He gonna run the house and get a knife to stab you?
So for that, I highly recommend, because I think it, yeah, for us, I think in the African-American community, we have always tried to, or were taught to stay away from, you know, guns and stuff like that. But you look up, you got these other folks, I won't mention any color or whatever, but they teach their babies how to shoot at like 4 and 5 years old. And we're taught when we see a gun to stay away from it, which is understandable. But that's why I think we need to talk about gun safety. Because obviously they're passing these motherfuckers out. I think they got guns in the vending machine or whatever it is. I mean, you could just go, they're very easy accessible. So I think that you have to arm yourself. You have to. Because they're not, these idiots, they're not going to stop making them, and they just getting dumber and dumber and dumber. And you, I highly, especially for the ladies too. Especially for the ladies, please do.
I mean, so like, let's go to this, because obviously,
like, I literally I sleep next to my shit.
Well, I mean, but of course, it's only, I think if people are gonna have gun, let it be people that are, they have to do a complete checkup on them. You have to get training on the gun. You know, yeah. That will understand. We know you're not about to go to no club and shoot nobody because you're not mentally nuts or you're not just carrying it. I mean, are you allowed to carry it outside your house?
Yes.
You have license to carry it?
Yes.
How did you go about getting a license to carry a gun?
You well, Illinois, you can apply for your, it's called a concealed carry, and you have to take 16 hours with an instructor. Part of it is classroom, part of it is range training. So it's a 16. I believe it vary. It may vary for different states, and stuff like that or whatever. But they really get you. Some instructors I've heard that they don't educate you. But my instructor, oh my goodness, he has. It's called Top Shot Academy, and he was amazing about, you know, really teaching us the laws and the responsibilities of carrying, and especially in Florida, because Florida is a different state. They got some different laws and shit going on.
Okay, so law abiding, somebody mentioned some of my law abiding citizens are not the ones killing people. Okay,
no. That's,
I agree to that. I'm just, you know, it's just, I'm just making a whole general statement. If, think about it, if nobody had guns, nobody would get shot. It's just that simple. You know what I mean? That's the bigger picture I'm looking at. If you look at countries that don't have guns, London and all, yes, people are going to find a legal way of getting it. You know, but a lot of time, guns become illegal after they become legal. People will legally go get a gun, and then next thing you know, they illegally give it to the wrong person or illegally sell it, you know. So most of the time, starts from A, coming from a legal person, you know. So they need to do better with it as far as, like, I mean, in this situation, is I don't know what happened, because as far as I'm reading, it's this bodyguard. That had, I'm assuming his bodyguard had license to carry the gun.
Yeah.
It says bodyguard shot him by accident.
Yeah, because they said it was somebody in the crew. So, could be. Now, he really need his ass kicked. Because another thing, too, about gun safety is they teach you how to assess a situation. You cannot come out and pull out. You have no business coming out, pulling out a gun, trying to shoot up a room full of people. Like, that's another thing. That's another thing they teach you.
One second. All right, so this is what somebody said. And all right, so, oh my God. So, take their security was up about to shoot back, and then took off, stood up by accident, and then he got shot.
Yeah. Yeah. Yep, that's also what I read. Yeah, that's exactly what I read. But again, you know, with things still developing, you know, you gotta be careful with this internet, you know. So that's all. But you know what? This makes me think about the other day I seen Amy Schumer. She shared a great skit about birth control. You know, I gotta go ask this person for birth control. So the skit ends with her at the pharmacy finally picking up her birth control, and it was so hard for her to get this birth control, and then a kid walks up right behind her, a little small kid, and he walks up and he said, can I get a gun? And the pharmacist threw him a gun. Like, that's how easy it is. It's hard to get. It's, you know, this country cares about our uteruses and things like that, and abortions and all the wrong shit, but it's so easy to get a gun. My son last year was telling me how that they're able to just buy them off the internet. Like, you can buy this piece, that, like, it's really, really, really simple. Like, I mean, you know, for years we've been hearing the conspiracies of, you know, governments dropping guns off, especially in underprivileged communities or whatever. But my son, who's a teenager, who, you know, who told me, he said, they're very easy to get off the internet. That's why I made sure that I educated him as well. He's not able to legally carry because he's not 21. Although he is in an open carry state, he's in now new, you know, he's in Louisiana for college, but he's still educated, you know, just in case he's in a situation where, you know, a gun falls out of the fucking sky and he's got to defend himself or whatever the case is. So, we have to change the narrative about the fear and who should be carrying guns, because these fools who not supposed to, they're going to keep picking them up. So the ones who I feel like you can and you can legally qualify for them, please go get you one.
And the thing about it, we understand what happened with Takeoff was accidental. But like I said last night, I went to a party where I didn't get to see nothing. Of course, because I think the shooting.